Hello friends, I am Anil once again in front of you on behalf of E-Dot Academy, and I am going to continue our 30 days revision class of CIB. So here's the next chapter for you, money supply and inflation. So money is nothing but that perform the four following functions. Number one is the money is medium of exchange. Money is measure of value. Money is also a store of value over the time. Money is the standard for deferred payment. Now, if you know what is the medium of exchange, that means in our society, when we purchase anything, that always comes out of money only. So that you can say money is considered as the medium of exchange. We can purchase, we can sell. And if you think about what is the measure of value, money, that means everything in this physical world is measured in terms of money only. When we record something, the value of anything, we say always in rupee or any other currency. And whenever we store something for the future use, in that also we measure the item in terms of money only. Okay. And for deferred payment, like in any future payment also, we measure in terms of money. So there are four functions. I repeat once again here. Money is the medium of exchange, measure of value, store for value, and standard for deferred payment. Yes, now next comes a very important, okay, very important regarding the money supply. So we'll be talking about here M1, M2, M3, M4. Here you must remember that M1 is known as narrow money and M3 is known as broad money. I'll repeat once again here, M1 is known as narrow money and M3 is known as broad money. Now, what is M1? Currency in public plus demand deposit with bank. Let's say if you are in bank, I just tell you a short technique how to remember M1, M2, M3 and M4. Suppose that you are in bank, okay, working in bank. Then whatever demand deposit is in bank plus currency in public and other deposit with RBI is known as M1. And this also M1 is called narrow money. M2. M2 means M1. That means whatever has been defined here as M1 plus saving deposit with post office. Keep in mind. That means I have taken all demand deposit with the banking system. If you talk about M2, that means in M1 you have to add only the saving deposit with post office. So M2 is nothing but M1 plus saving deposit with post office. Now M3. M3 nothing but means M1 plus time deposit by banking system. Means I am going to just write here, if you write here M1 here, you can just, you can have a pictorial presentation. M1 is here, M2 is here. You can see you go to post office, you become M2. Again, you come back to your bank, it is M3 only, but only thing you have to include the time deposit with banking system. M1 was the only saving deposit with the bank. That means when you calculate the M3, you have to add M1 plus time deposit with the banking system. Okay, then we talk about what is M4. M4 means now you M3 means M3, then you get the M4 here. So likewise, you can make the sequence M1, M3, M4 and sidewise you can keep M2. Okay, M1. M2 is the left hand side, or you can take right hand side, no problem. M1, M3 and M4. Why? Because M1, from M1 you get M2. So M2 is nothing but M1 plus saving deposit with the post office. M3, M1 plus time deposit with the, then how you get M4? So after adding here M3 only. So this is the sequence you can remember. I just repeat here what is M1, M2, M3, M4. What are the causes of inflation? So inflation is basically caused by demand pull inflation and cost push inflation. Demand pull means when there is demand of certain commodity in society, that means naturally the cost will be more, demand will be more. That is called, if demand is more, the inflation will rise. And cost push inflation means when there is increase in cost of a thing, means if cost of production is increased, naturally the inflation will increase. And how will you measure the inflation? That is the main question. Inflation is measured in percentage. And how to calculate inflation? There is one formula. This price index in current year minus price index in base year divided by price index in base year. Keep in mind, means I'll write here on formula here. You can see current year and base year. So I'll write BY here and again divide by BY, base year, and into 100. Why I'm writing here 100? Because you have to convert into percentage. Okay, that means inflation is always expressed in percentage. When, so that means when we calculate into percentage, so price index in current year, if it is, we are going to calculate for the current year, means 21-22. So your current year will be 21-22. Base year, whatever base year we are going to, let's say base year we are going to 11-12. So base year, whatever the price index is there, again BY, whatever the cost in 11-12 is there, then into 100. So we'll get the inflation in percentage. And there are basically four types of price indices. Number one is WPI, number two is FII, that means, and number third is CPI, and fourth is called GDP deflator. WPI stands for wholesale price index. FII means food inflation index. CPI is consumer price index, and GDP deflator means whenever the new commodity is produced or added in services, due to that increase we call GDP deflator. So whole price index reflect the change in level of price of a basket of goods at wholesale level. That means government put certain commodities and they calculate what is the change in the cost of the commodities at wholesale level. Keep in mind, wholesale level. Okay. Wherein CPI, consumer level. So you have to differentiate this wholesale price and CPI means, CPI means consumer level. So this is the base difference here. And one more thing here. WPI is also known as headline inflation, and it is the official inflation index of Government of India. That means Government of India always focus on the WPI. That's why headline inflation is called. And WPI is announced in monthly basis. And there is one more change here, very important. Base year has been changed for WPI as 2011 and 12, effective from April 2017. That means with effect from April 2017, there is change in base year. We wrote the formula, no, cost price in current year minus base year. So this is the, that means now we are calculating the base year as a 2011 and 12. Okay, whereas food group, will be announced in weekly basis, because some of the commodities now, which look like food and item and fuel item, the for that price index is released on weekly basis. That means WPI is released on monthly basis, whereas the food item and fuel item, these are released on weekly basis. Now, consumer price index, I told you consumer price index as reflect, it is at consumer level. Okay, there is also basket of goods are, but that means consumer level, that means wholesale consumer. And CPI is the cost of living index, popularly known as core inflation, CC. That means these two names are here, CPI, consumer price index, and core inflation. Understood? Similarly, WPI, also known as headline inflation, that you can keep in mind. And coming next, that means CPI is divided into basically four parts. And four parts are here. CPI for industrial worker, like banking system, they are following this. When you get something DA, so they follow this system only. CPI for industrial worker, CPI for agriculture labor, and number third is CPI for rural laborers, and CPI for urban non-manual employees. Okay, so this is the regarding the CPI. Now next come, who releases CPI? So CPI is released by, this is very important, keep in mind, CPI is released by Labor Bureau, Ministry of Labor and Employment, Government of India. I repeat here, CPI is released by Labor Bureau, Ministry of Defense. That means that Labor Bureau comes under the Ministry of Labor and Employment, Government of India. Whereas WPI is released by CSO. CSO stands for Central Statistical Organization. Central Statistical Organization in Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation. So there's two industries are involved, one for CPI, other for WPI. Okay, CPI is released by Labor Bureau, Ministry of Labor, Employment, Government of India. WPI is released by CSO, Central Statistical Organization in Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation. Number one, okay. Consumer price index, how consumer price index was started, compilation and maintenance. Consumer price index was started with effect from 1943, okay, on the recommendation of Rao Court of Inquiry. That in that time, this was 1947, okay. So you can remember this one, before 1947, India got freedom. So since 1943, on the recommendation of Rao Court of Inquiry, CPI was implemented in India. Okay, now GDP deflator is nothing but is measure of level of price of all new, here's the main point, key point is a new domestically produced final goods and services in India. That means it is the level of price only new, keep in mind, not old one. Not old one, that means things are already available in our country. We don't consider the cost of that. Okay, new. Okay, so the GDP deflator is not based in the fixed, that's why there is no fixed basket. Okay, now moving ahead, we have come to the business cycle. Okay, in any economy, when somebody performs a certain type of business, he always sees ups and down in the business. That means sometimes profit is there, sometimes loss is there, sometimes downward trend is there, sometimes upward trend is there. That trend is known as business cycle. And there is one more name for the business cycle, is very important, sometimes is asked, an economic cycle. Okay, so business cycle is also known as economic cycle. That means business cycle always follow a fluctuation trend. Okay, there is always fluctuation in business cycle. That means business will come. And what is the cycle? So you might have seen some curve like this. So if you draw the curve like this, so business cycle also look like this. This type of curve. Okay, सो दिस टाइप ऑफ है ना, टॉप कर्व बॉटम कर्व है ना. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू सी व्हाट आर द नेम्स ऑफ द टॉप बॉटम एंड स्लाइडिंग एंड अपवर्ड. सो वन मोर थिंग इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट रिगार्डिंग इज दैट बिजनेस साइकिल इज समटाइम्स बिकम वेरी अनप्रिडिक्टेबल. समटाइम्स है ना बिजनेस साइकिल इज नॉट रेगुलर प्रिडिक्टेबल रिपीटेटिव फिनोमिना लाइक यू माइट हैव सीन अ स्विंग ऑफ पेंडुलम और क्लॉक. सो यू हैव टू रिमेंबर दैट बिजनेस साइकिल इज नॉट ए रेगुलर एंड प्रिडिक्टेबल. दैट मीन्स इज अप्स एंड डाउन्स विल नॉट बी रेगुलर. दैट यू कैनॉट से ओके नाउ दिस गोइंग टू बी ट्रेंड इज गोइंग टू बी डाउन. सो बिजनेस साइकिल इज सिंक्रोनस कैन सी. And business cycle also show a wave-like moment. I told you it shows wave-like moment, ups and down. You can see like this, and like this wave is there. If I try here like this, and business cycle is also recurring in nature. That means if business cycle has fluctuated, that means this fluctuation may come in future also. And depression in business cycle is not predictable or not definite. Understood? So that means whole business cycle is divided into four category, and BRDR. So we call it a BRDR. So that means that BRDR, boom, recession, depression and recovery. Okay, so boom, I just draw a graph here. So here's a boom, top means your business is running very good condition, na? Boom, here is your boom. And recession, now when your business is going down, this period is called recession. Okay, depression, now your business is nothing, loss, everything is loss, unemployment has increased, labor is not getting wages, na? And then it's come recovery phase. So this is the recovery phase, boom, na? Recession or and depression, and here is the recovery. So you can remember like this, right? BRDR, boom, recession, depression and recovery. Now we'll see what are the characteristics of each. Yeah, during the boom phase, production capacity is fully utilized, right? These words are being asked sometimes, they will give the phrase and they will see what is the phase of this business cycle. So you must keep in boom capacity. That means your whatever the production you are doing, whatever factory you are running, that means that full utilization, product fetch on above normal price, which gives higher profit, and consumption will be decreased as price going up. Because why this recession starts? Because you keep on increasing the price of the commodity, then what will happen? The people will start consuming less. That's why after boom, recession may start. I'm telling may because it's not regular. Right? So downward tendency demand is observed and supply exceeds demand and desire for liquidity increase all around. Okay. That means after boom, producer is compelled to reduce price so that they can find money to meet their obligations. When the cost is increased, that means people start consuming less. Okay, then there will be less demand of the commodity. And here is the recession will start. After recession, again depression will start. And underemployment, both men and material. Okay, because now depression, everything is not working fine. So that is called depression. And recovery, slowly after depression, recovery will start. So that is called the recovery. Here are the four phases of business cycle. Once again, I read here, boom, recession, depression and recovery. BRDR, you can remember like this. So these are very also important. Okay, now moving ahead. Very important theories of interest, and here we'll be discussing basically about the Keynes theory. Yeah? So again, name of Keynes is coming here, J.M. Keynes. So J.M. Keynes is back once again. So he wrote one book. Yeah? In the previous video, we discussed the name of this J.M. Keynes. So General Theory of Employment interest and money. Keep in mind, interest is the key word for the J.M. Keynes scheme. Okay, so you can remember the keywords now. So J.M. Keynes, the main, the interest is the key word for the J.M. Keynes. So he wrote the book General Theory of Employment, Interest and Money. So we'll see what was the theory of J.M. Keynes. So as per his theory, that means there are three elements can be distinguished in it. In case of interest, payment for risk involved in making the loan. That means why we are charging the interest. As per J.M. Keynes, why we are charging the interest from somebody. So he has explained, that means we are taking interest because payment for risk involved. Risk factor is there. We'll get our capital or not. Payment for trouble involved. We are getting trouble to pay the money. Okay. Understood. And payment for use of money. Because you are using money, so give me my some money, some part of money back. And J.M. Keynes also explained in his book that interest rate is purely monetary phenomena. That means we charge interest only in case of this. In that means we'll charge interest only in terms of money only. Not that we give something them and you take services of other things. So as per J.M. Keynes, interest is purely monetary phenomena. You can see the keywords here. So J.M. Keynes, as per J.M. Keynes, interest is purely monetary phenomena. And J.M. Keynes' theory is also known as liquidity preference theory. Sometimes they will ask you, what is the name of theory of interest given by J.M. Keynes? So this is very popularly known as liquidity preference theory. Okay. So J.M. Keynes' theory is also known as liquidity preference theory. And one more thing, that means if you talk about the bond and interest, so rate of interest and bond price are inversely proportional. That means if rate of interest is increasing, bond price will fall. And vice versa, if rate of interest is decreasing, bond price will increase. So you have to remember this question is asked many times. And we'll be doing some case study also in the later videos. That means if rate of interest is more, bond price will be less. If rate of interest is less, bond price will be more, and vice versa. And as per J.M. Keynes, the rate of interest is also determined by demand for money and supply of money. It's a very natural phenomenon. If demand of money is more, that means rate of interest will be more. And is now opposite to supply of money. If supply of money is more, rate of interest will go down. Okay. So that you have to remember as per your experience, no. Demand of something is more than rate of interest will be more. And supply is more, something is like commodities, no? You can think of the money also. If supply is more, rate of interest will go down. Okay. And one more important, IS and LM curve was promulgated by Hicks and Hansen. This popularly known as two economists are here. Sir Horn Richard Hicks and Alvin Hansen. This name you can remember. IS and LM curve. Okay. So, that means what Hicks and Hansen has done. That means he plotted two curves. He studies the IS curve. So, he plotted IS curve and LM curve in one graph only. Between two variables. This is also important. This question has been asked once. Okay. Two variables. So one variable is income, another variable is rate of interest. Okay. And he intersected these two graphs and point of intersection of two curves is known as equilibrium rate of interest. Okay, so equilibrium rate of interest, that means this studies has been done by two economists. I'll repeat the names here once again: Sir Horne Richards Hicks and Alvin Hansen. And here is LM stand for liquidity preference and money supply. And LM curve is derived from Keynes liquidity preference theory of interest, whereas the IS is the classical theory. This is also known as, as you can sometimes is asked, what are the two theories has been combined in finding the these IS and LM curves. You can under must remember this. LM curve is derived from Keynes liquidity preference theory of interest, whereas IS is a classical theory. Okay, so with this we finish our this video, and we'll see you in the next video. Till then, bye. Have a nice day. Okay, you can subscribe my channel if you like it, and you can also recommend to your friends. Have a nice day. Enjoy.